Found it! Found it! It's here somewhere. Looking. Give me a break.
Too dark. Can't see a thing.
Yes, that's a thing called mouth. Look here.
Wait. I think. Aha! I found it.
Finally! Let's get out of here. Quickly.
What's going on?
Rarity, I came as soon as I heard. What happened?
Oh, Twilight! It's awful, horrible, dreadful, perhaps even the worst possible thing!
Uh-huh. And that would be...
Why, Twilight? Do I detect skepticism? Well, I shall have you know that last night I became a victim. A tragic, tragic victim. Woe is me. I shall never recover from this injury that's been brought upon me.
English, Rarity.
I was in the zone, Twilight. But if I must, last night I was stolen from...
Stolen from? What was stolen?
They were stolen, Twilight! Both of them!
Who?
My two jewels! True Blue and Oppo!
Ahem. Twilight, what Rarity is trying to say is that thieves broke into the Carousel Boutique last night and stole both the True Blue, a large sapphire that she had recently acquired when gem hunting, and Opal, which is her, her cat.
How could they? How could they? Oh, my poor, poor darling, all alone out there with those ruffians!
I'm gonna go ahead and hope that she was talking about her cat there. What happened? Do you have any idea who did this?
Well, no. I'm afraid we haven't the slightest idea.
Ponyville doesn't really have much of a police force, you see, so we are a little under-equipped to handle something like this. This doesn't happen very often, you know. An investigative team from Canterlot has agreed to look into it, but I'm afraid they won't be here for a few days.
A few days? But the thieves might be long gone by then, and... Wait, is this the same investigative team as last time?
Exactly what happened last time? I can't seem to recall.
The one brought in to investigate the baby that went missing and which ended up being found unharmed in the closet?
Ah, yes. I do recall that. But I'm not sure where you're going with.
The one that somehow managed to implicate Pinkie Pie in a fictional Dragon Egg smuggling ring?
Well, yes. Yes, that's the one. Think positive, Twilight. They may, perform better this time. Yes, that's the ticket. Well, there's not much for it either way, Twilight. After all, no pony in our town has any experience with this sort of thing. We'll just have to wait it out. Oh, I have so much to do at the moment. I simply can't stay around any longer. We'll get to the bottom of this as soon as that investigative team arrives, Rarity. You have my word.
I'm afraid she's right, you know. We shall simply have to wait it out.
If that investigative team gets their hooves on this case, who knows what ridiculous things they might come up with this time. There has to be a better way. Rarity, I'm on the case.
I beg your pardon, Twilight?
Some pony needs to get to the bottom of this, right? Well, I volunteer. I've had experience investigating crime before, after all.
Twilight, I'm really not sure if that's such a grand idea.
Well, I mean, sure, that particular investigation pretty much involved completely airtight evidence that directly identified the culprits in one go. And it also included an eyewitness who saw almost everything who could lead me exactly to the clues. But it's not like the team from Canterlot will be much better, right?
Forgive me, Twilight, if your words do not inspire a great deal of confidence.
It'll be fine. Don't you worry, Rarity. I'll have this case wrapped up in a jiffy. Mystery novels came through for me then, so surely they'll come through for us again.
Hey!
Gah! Pinkie! Where in Equestria did you come from?
Oh, well, I was walking by and I was all, my assistance is needed and I must fulfill my duty.
Uh-huh. What are you doing?
Helping a pony in need. Duh!
I'm the one who knows something about investigations, not you. Remember what happened last time?
Of course I do, silly! But this time is completely different! I have, wait for it, a walkthrough!
A what?
A walkthrough, silly! For this game, the way things work are completely different than last time! Honestly, sometimes I worry about her.
Pinky, you're talking to some bushes.
Twilight, I'm not talking to those old things. I'm talking to them! Out there! Do you see what I have to work with here?
You know what? I'm not even going to ask. Just, do your thing, Pinky.
Okie dokie, Pinky. Well, the first step of any investigation is to move around. You can't find anything if you don't move your little rock to where the clues are. So, to walk places, lift your hoof up and move it in front of your other hoof.
Pinky, I'm pretty sure I know how to walk.
Oh, right! But I bet you've never walked like this before. Now, if you want her to walk, well, you just gotta click on the spot you want her to walk to and she goes. Or, if you want her to keep moving, just press and hold and she'll walk towards your cursor. And, of course, if you wanted to get somewhere lickety-split, just double-click and hold, and she'll run, run, run like the wind!
I'm pretty sure I can walk myself.
Oh, Twilight, don't you worry your pretty little head about the details. They'll figure it out, and that's a pinky promise!
Okay, so now we know how to move. Great, but what about, you know, examining evidence?
Oh, that's simple! If you want to talk to someone or look at something, all you gotta do is click on it! Why, I bet if you clicked on that broken window there, you'd think of lots of things to say about it.
It's just a window.
Yeah, but you gotta keep them happy, right? So you better think of something to say about it. Otherwise, they might get upset.
Right, of course. We wouldn't want to make them upset after all.
And that's it!
That's it?
That's it! Well, you're not ready for those is yet, though. Don't you worry about them.
Okay.
Okie dokie, and I'm off! Bye, Twilight! And I'll see you real soon, too. Catch you later!
That was fascinating, was it not?
That's one way to describe it.
But useful, wouldn't you say? Though, I must confess, I still do not believe that this is a good idea.
Don't worry, Verity. I'll get to the bottom of this before that investigation team even gets here. The boutique's looking as good as ever. I thought we'd never get it fully repaired after Cheerilee literally tore its front wall away from the rest of the building. Oh, then along came Pinkie Pie. Then a song started. Then a chorus joined in. I don't even know where they came from. And then somehow, 3 minutes later, the Carousel Boutique was good as new. One of these days, I really have to resume my studies of Pinkie. Wow, these are some really nice bushes. Very eye-catching. So much that you might think that they're important. But they're not. Well, that's sure one way to get into a building.
You'd think a jewel thief would be more, well, subtle than that.
The tree that Opalescence keeps getting stuck in. It seems to have become a bit of a habit of hers, ever since Rainbow Dash put her there to convince Rarity to come out of her room. One time, Winona chased her up that tree. Applejack was awfully apologetic, but we spent quite a while trying to convince her to come down. Then another time, Rainbow Dash was practicing her aerial acrobatics and kind of messed something up, causing her to crash right into Carousel Boutique and making poor Opal scurry up that tree once again. And then there was a time that the Cutie Mark Crusaders were trying to get their cutie marks in interpretive dance. I don't really know exactly what happened, but by the time they were done, we had a tiger loose in Ponyville, Verity's hair was on fire, and Opalescence was back up in the tree. Again. Needless to say, Verity did not like their, interpretation of dance. Anyway, she's not in the tree this time. Surprisingly enough. Well, it doesn't take a sharp eye to see that these are tire marks. And it doesn't take a sharp wit to figure out that whoever was here probably was the cause of this broken window, too. Is there anything else here? Is this hair? Between the hair and the tire marks, now that she mentions it. If we assume that this hair is from some animal, then it'd naturally follow that the rider probably swerved here to avoid hitting it, explaining why that pony went towards the window. Except, what animal was it? A pony, perhaps? Strange star-shaped object? I can't say I know what this is, but it looks out of place, which makes it a clue in my book. Rarity, I think we should start with what happened last night.
Of course, darling. What would you like to know?
Could you describe exactly what happened and what you saw?
Well, I'm afraid there isn't much to tell. I was sleeping in my bedroom when suddenly I heard a shrill crash from downstairs. I went downstairs to investigate, and what did I find but my house overturned and ransacked, my prized jewel gone, and my beloved Opal Essence missing as well. Oh, Opal! Mama's coming soon!
Perhaps I should ask more specifically about what was stolen. And that was everything there is to speak of? You saw nothing else at all?
No, nothing, I'm afraid. So sorry, Twilight.
That sounded awfully suspicious. Rarity, are you hiding something? Ah! Pinky, what are... Actually, you know what? Never mind. I can guess.
Ooh, can I guess too? Is it a bread box?
Pinky, just get on with it.
Get on with what?
Aren't you here to tell me what to do here?
Nope. Why? What's going on?
Well, for one, I think Rarity's hiding something from me.
Oh, you mean the topic got lost.
The what now? Strange book she's got there.
Okay, you ready for this? And I mean really, really ready?
Yes?
Okay, here goes. Sometimes a character won't want to tell you everything. In other words, they're hiding something from you!
Yeah, I think that was established already. Asylum, if I wasn't worried about what she would do to it. Could you describe everything that was stolen last night?
Of course! First there was True Blue, a regular hunk of a sapphire that shone in the light like a noonday sky. Oh, whatever shall I do without the light of that jewel in my workshop? Second, there was Opal, my darling, darling Opal! She's been missing since last night too. Now with the jewel I can understand, but what could the thieves possibly want with Opal? It greatly troubles me to think of what might have happened to her. You must find them both, Twilight. Promise me. You must. You must.
I'll do my best, Rarity. I promise. Not just a giant sapphire, but her cat too? What in Equestria could that be about? Alright, let's think about this logically here. Hair this color and this length is pretty rare, as far as Equestria goes. There really aren't any ponies that it could have come from. In fact, the only creature that I can think of that it could have come from is Opalescence. And that would mean that whoever was here swerved and crashed into the window because Opalescence was in his or her path. And that would all come together to mean that this broken window likely was an accident. It feels like there's more to this than just that. But it's a start at least. This is from... Pinky, stop doing that! I'm trying to concentrate here.
Oh, sorry, but I thought you might really like to know this latest thing I found in the walkthrough.
What is it?
Well, if you get a piece of evidence that someone might know about, then after you start talking to them, you can click on Present Evidence, and they'll let you know what they know about it. Pretty neat, huh?
I'm supposed to do what to what now?
Twilight, honestly, what am I gonna do with you? Well, you know what I meant, right? So it'll all work out peachy keen in the end. I just know!
fill me with confidence, Pinky.
Well, that's all I got. See you now, Twilight. Till next time!
Just a flower bush. Nothing special, really. Although, now that I take a closer look, there's a ball here. With a note? Sometimes a pony just has a plain old ball emergency, and that's why I've set these up. Play around with it as much as you like. Just make sure you return it here when you're done with it. Wouldn't want some pony to have a ball emergency and not be able to solve it. Okie dokie, Loki. Somehow, I get a sense for who put this here. You know, I always see those tents when I come by here, but I've never actually learned what they are. Maybe they're merchants. Seems like they'd be closer to Town Square, though. Or gypsies? I'd have thought they would have left by now if so. Or maybe it's all a big front for a secret group of dragon egg smugglers, and they're all hoping that, just like I have all this time, we pay them no mind because they're just tents of no consequence in the background. When all this time, right under our noses, they've been shifting dozens upon dozens of illicit dragon eggs to a shadowy, nefarious crime boss! Nah, probably gypsies.
Case, darling.
Don't worry, Verity. Every little bit of information helps.
Of course! Apple Bloom came by this morning to have this little accident fixed up. She seemed to have ripped her cape during one of her usual excursions. I asked her why she didn't just get Sweetie Belle to fix it up, but she said that Sweetie Belle was very busy today and couldn't spare any time to do so. I really don't know what those fillies are up to, but on the other hoof, perhaps it's better I don't know. I swear, sometimes I don't understand myself. Sweetie Belle absolutely ruined my gold silk, and now here I am, fixing the capes they made with it. I'm an odd sort. Do you think I'm odd, Twilight?
Oh, Rarity. I think you just have a big heart.
Don't remind me, Twilight. Sometimes it can be a bit tiresome.
So this belonged to Apple Bloom, and she had it fixed this morning. While I'm here, Verity, do you know where Apple Bloom went after you fixed her cape?
I'm not certain of her exact whereabouts, but she did head out towards the town square after I gave her the fixed cape. Perhaps that should be where you should search?
All right. Thanks, Verity.
Can you do that for me, Sweetie Belle? At least until this all blows over.
Of course! Leave it to me, Apple Bloom! See ya!
I wonder what those two are talking about. Official Cutie Mark Crusader business, maybe? Might as well have a chat with Apple Bloom while she's here. around before. Are you new here?
Yes. Well, no. Well, sort of. I travel a lot around Equestria. I haven't been in Ponyville for quite some time, so... mostly.
Well, welcome back then. My name is Twilight Sparkle. I'm Princess Celestia's student, but, well, in my day job, I take care of the town library, too.
Oh, of course. I've heard of you. One of your exploits do have a way of reaching quite far away, let me tell you.
Do they? Well, I'm really nothing to speak about, to be honest. But it's nice to make your acquaintance all the same. So, what do you do?
I'm a sculptor. Or at least, that's what I most enjoy. Traveling helps me a lot with inspiration.
Oh, sculpting! Have you seen our town's fountain? You might like it.
Well, actually, I've seen it before. Or, well, I've done more than just seen it. I made it a while ago.
Wow, really? I had no idea. Well, you should feel proud of it. It's very well done.
Thank you. Although, there is one thing that catches my eye, now that I think about it.
What's that?
That plaque. Was that added recently? It wasn't put there when I made it, at least. And I didn't make it for the mayor. The Rich family commissioned the statue.
She... wait, what? Huh, boy. I wish this surprised me anymore.
Anyways, I was in the middle of pondering my next sculpture. It was very nice meeting you, Twilight Sparkle.
Likewise. Beautifully carved statue. I wonder what it's for. Oh, hey, there's a dedication here. Erected in honor of the bravest, most upright public servant Ponyville has ever known. I'm getting the sense that this is talking about the mayor, and was written by the mayor. Are you cleaning a dirt road?
No, I'm giving it a massage because it is gross.
I just meant it was kind of odd.
So it's the guy who hired me to do this. He wanted every surface around his house free of dirt and dust, including the road.
That pony must really dislike dirt.
And I've been out here for the past 5 hours. Every time it starts looking clean, a breeze or a crowd comes by forcing me to start all over.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that.
Don't be. It's getting by the hour.
What's this crowd all about? I didn't know there was an event today.
They're having an apple-eating contest!
Yeah, Applejack's way in the lead.
Applejack! Applejack! Applejack!
Whoa, if she eats all those apples, she might get a wicked bad tummy ache. Oh, hello. My name is Twilight Sparkle. Are you new in town? I don't think I've ever seen you before.
Well, duh. I'm a time traveler. Name's Abby Sparkles.
What now? I've seen weird introductions before, but sheesh.
A time traveler. But my time machine broke down, so now I'm kind of stuck here. For now, at least. So I'm trying to make a living as best as I can. Nice place you got here, although a little rustic, if I may say so.
Breathe, Twilight. Breathe. So, how exactly are you a time traveler? Time travel spells are incredibly high level. I mean, I only managed to go back in time a week, and even then I only had less than a minute.
Oh, Twilight, you need to think outside the box. You've got to know how the impossible becomes possible. Or something like that. Memento was a bit of a cute. But I guess what I'm trying to say is that I built a time machine, and, well, now I'm here.
Uh-huh. And I'm secretly a robot. With mysterious powers.
Really? Huh. I didn't think they had robots in this age. Hold on. Let me get some tools and open you up and have a look at how you work.
Ah! No. I was joking. Sheesh.
Oh? Huh. You had me convinced with how robotic you were acting.
Even ponies from the future don't give me a break. Cutie Mark Crusaders. Done any, you know, epic quests or crusading lately?
Oh, well, no, actually. Not really. See, we're kinda on break.
On break? Since when do the Cutie Mark Crusaders take breaks?
Since, well, recently. I mean, every pony's gotta take a break once in a while, right?
How recently?
Pretty recent?
Why is she avoiding my questions? Something's not right here. Although, now that I think about it, there's one crusader I haven't heard anything about today. Say, Apple Bloom, do you know where Scootaloo's been?
Nowhere. I mean, somewhere. I mean, not here. I mean, I don't know.
So, did you hear about what happened to Rarity last night?
Did I? That was an awful thing to happen to her!
Well, don't worry. I'm on the case. And I promise you that I'll find the one who broke that window and stole from her.
Well, good luck with that. Hope you have real good luck there!
That was an odd response. Apple Bloom, you wouldn't happen to know anything about what happened, would you?
Huh? Course not! Why would you think I'm not telling you something, huh?
Because you just told me that you're not. Okay, Apple Bloom. Time to find out what you're hiding.
Hold it!
Pinky, what in the world are you doing?
I'm pressing you for information, Buster! Or... at least that's what the walkthrough says. I'm not really quite sure how this is supposed to work here.
Another lesson from Professor Pinkie Pie?
Yuffaroony! This time we're talking about... interrogations! Are you excited? I'm super duper excited with a strawberry on top!
Don't you mean cherry?
No, I don't really like cherries.
But you... I mean the whole ride home with Rarity. Never mind. Let's just get this over with.
Okie dokie dokie! Now, the walkthrough says that interrogations are a super special thing where you've got to try to wring the truth out of your opponent. And you do this with your mind, Twilight! Your mind! I guess you should have no problem with all that mind you got, huh?
Sure. So, what do?
Well, she's about to tell you something that totally isn't true! Well, part of it at least. It's your job to figure out what that part is! Once you find a statement that doesn't fit with the evidence you have available, you'll want to present that evidence against that statement! Like so! This!
Can I do it without that last part?
Well, if you want to be boring, sure!
Boring is fine. Boring is great!
Oh, and if you think you need your opponent to talk more about something they said, you can always select Press for Info! You'll get them to talk! Like me! I love talking!
I've noticed.
And that's all for now! But remember, you gotta use pizzazz! Otherwise, you're not a real investigator! The walkthrough says so!
Duly noted.
Jeez! Do something lighten her up a bit, would ya? She's a terrible audience! Anyway, until next time, bye!
Thought she'd never leave. Okay, on with the investigation. Apple Bloom, I need to ask you about where you were around the time of the crime.
Huh? How come? I'm not a suspect, am I?
No, no. I just need to know. Procedure and all. That makes sense, right?
Sure, I guess. I wasn't really doing a whole lot yesterday, to be perfectly honest. Most of my day was spent with Applejack helping her on the farm. We finished everything up at around 6:30 or 7. I don't remember exactly what it was.
Just a minute. Why can't you remember exactly when it was?
Because I was outside. Duh! We need old fancy pants ponies with the watches and stuff. That's for Camelot ponies!
That doesn't account for your whole day, though. What about the rest of it?
I had homework to complete for school after that, so I was pretty much just doing that for the rest of the day.
Just a minute. That took up the whole day?
Why, you have no idea how scary this chairlift can be in the classroom.
Do tell.
After Family Appreciation Day, every pony in the whole class had to write an essay on how it's bad to sleep in class when some pony else is talking.
That doesn't seem so bad.
Oh, we didn't. Except for the fact that she wanted us to explain our position on why it's bad, and what bad is using classical philosophers' argument as a basis. Jeremy Van Hoof will haunt me to the grave, to the grave!
This is an elementary school?
I certainly never went anywhere near Carousel Boutique. No, sorry!
Just a minute. I didn't ask about the Carousel Boutique.
Oh, well, I still didn't. I mean, that's where the crime happened, right? So naturally, I figured you were asking about that. And I wasn't. So there.
If you say so.
So, I don't know if I can really help you much here, Twi. Awful sorry.
Aha! This proves that you're not being truthful with me, Applebloom.
No, it doesn't, Twi.
Nice! Well, you passed that test with flying colors. Well done, Applebloom.
You don't really know what you're doing, do ya?
Nice deduction. Wanna take over?
So, I don't know if I can really help you much here, Twi. Awful sorry.
This just can't be right. But I can't find anything wrong with what she's saying yet. Wait a second. Objection!
Twilight, what in the hell are you doing?
Well, I wanted to give it, you know, pizzazz, just like the real thing. Did it sound official?
Why, you feeling all right? Hey, I bet Zecora can help with that.
Okay, I get it. I'm not a lawyer. Anyways, Applebloom, I'm afraid to say that I don't think you're being honest with me here.
Huh? Of course I am, Twy. How could you say something like that?
Oh no, I'm not being guilt-tripped this time. I found a scrap of your cape near the bridge to the Carousel Boutique. I know you were there, Applebloom.
Oh, well, that doesn't mean I was left here last night, does it? Why, that was left here a long time ago, Twi!
No, Applebloom, I'm afraid that one's not going to fly. I talked to Rarity earlier, and she told me that you had this fixed this morning.
Yeah, but...
your prized Cutie Mark Crusader's cape. Applebloom, come on. You can't tell me that you wouldn't get that fixed as soon as possible.
Alright, you win, Twi. I'm sorry.
It's okay. But please, I need you to tell me what you know. I can't help if I don't know as much as possible. All right, Applebloom. Please tell me everything you know about what happened last night.
I can't.
And why not?
'Cause I can't.
Applebloom, I think I know why you're not talking. How's this? You're trying to protect Scootaloo, aren't you? I haven't heard from her all day, and Rarity said some things about you three that seemed awfully suspicious.
Yeah, you got it, Twa.
Applebloom, listen to me. I know your heart is in the right place, but this isn't the right way to protect Scootaloo. There's an investigative team coming in from Canterlot to handle this case. It's very, very important that I have this case closed before they get here.
You don't mean that investigation team, do ya?
I'm afraid I do.
Okay, I get it. I get it, Twa. No more hiding, promise. I wasn't being truthful because, well, I was awful worried about Scootaloo. See, last night, we were rehearsing a comedy routine that we had planned to put on for Rarity's birthday, which is coming up pretty soon. We've been doing that for quite a while now.
Oh, right. Comedy, of course. Great.
Well, yeah, this'll learn all cutie marks for sure. But you can't tell any pony about this, Twa. This is super duper top secret. It won't work if it's not a surprise.
Sure. You can trust me. Cross my heart and hope to fly. Stick a cupcake in my eye.
Then yes?
Yes.
Well, all right then. Anyway, we were practicing in the town square last night, like always, and things are going pretty well. We took a break, during which time me and Sweetie Belle hung out by the bridge. But I don't know where Scootaloo was at that time, or what she was up to. A short while after that, we heard a sudden loud crash coming from Paris over the beach. We didn't know what in tarnation was happening now, so we just watched for a bit to see what was going on. And then a little while after that, some pony ran across the bridge real fast. We didn't even get a good look at it, but I'm pretty sure it was Scootaloo, Twa.
What? Oh, no, that can't be right.
Right it is, Twa. I didn't know what was going on, but since it seemed like Scootaloo was in trouble, we all figured, well, better not say anything about it. I'm awful sorry I lied to you, Twa.
It's fine, really. You did the right thing in telling me all this. This has been a big help.
Scootaloo's not a thief, Twa! You gotta believe me! You gotta help her! Promise!
I promise on my honor as an investigator that I will clear Scootaloo's name and get to the bottom of this.
Is that something that's valuable?
Let's just say that, yes, I promise. Now I know that Verity's hiding something from me. I'd better pay her another visit. Don't you think you might have seen something?
I suppose you do have a point.
Thanks, Celestia. It worked.
You are correct, Twilight. I did see Skooloo last night. I did not know what to make of it, and then to protect her, I do apologize for not being forthright about it.
I understand, Rarity. But if that investigation team from Canterlot comes here and finds any of that out, what do you think their conclusion is going to be?
You do have a point, I must say.
All right. Time to get to the bottom of this. All right, Rarity. Please tell me everything you know about what you saw last night. I can't help if I don't have all the details.
Of course, Twilight. I shall do my best.
I finished my work for yesterday earlier than expected, so I had wanted to get my beauty sleep. I had been somewhat deprived, given that a certain client had made several last-minute orders.
Just a minute. Which certain client was this, out of curiosity?
Who else but Sapphire Shores? She gives me such good business. But I don't want to gossip, of course, but my goodness, does that man love jewels, Twilight? Although, I suppose her request was what got me searching for gems, which was what caused me to find True Blue in the first place. It wasn't so bad, all things told. Well, as soon as I get True Blue back, that is. Intent?
Right, so anyway, you had just gone to sleep?
I had finally fallen into a blissful, restful sleep when, all of a sudden, I awoke to the sound of a loud crash coming from the first floor!
Just a minute. What kind of crash are we talking about, exactly?
The kind of crash that a window makes when it gets broken. Honestly, Twilight, I dare say I needn't spell this one out for you.
Right. So, what did you do when you heard this crash?
Well, I was just scared out of my wits at that moment, so I made great haste downstairs to see what in Celestia's name was going on!
Just a minute. If there were potentially dangerous thieves in your home, why would you have gone downstairs so quickly? Weren't you worried for your safety?
I suppose that I did not even consider the possibility that I might have been in danger, now that you mention it. But really, Twilight, that's rather beside the point, is it not? What I found there was... oh, terrible! Horrible! The first floor of my boutique! Ransacked! Ruined! Torn apart! Oh, what is a man to do?
Just a minute. Wow, you seem pretty upset. I'm sorry.
Of course I'm upset! All that time put into organization and sorting and everything like that. Ruined! Just ruined! Now I'm going to have to put all that work into sorting the first floor all over again!
That's what has her upset? I know I can be a bit obsessive about organization, but sheesh!
Worse still! True Blue, my prized jewel, was gone! Snatched from my very home! And worst of all, the very first thing I saw when I arrived was an orange and purple pony darting out my door!
Just a minute! Rarity, this is incredibly important. Please tell me exactly what it was you saw here. Was there any chance, any at all, that what you saw wasn't Skootaloo?
Well, I'm afraid that it all went by so fast that I didn't get a very good look. I had to turn on the lights before I could see anything at all. And by that time, it had very nearly left. All I can say is that it was definitely something moving. And that I clearly saw the colors orange and purple.
But what about her cape? You didn't see that at all?
All I saw was her backside. Perhaps the cape had gotten wrapped around her front when she crashed through the window. I don't know, Twilight. If that does not describe Skootaloo, then who would it describe?
Is she really the only pony who fits that description? Think, Twilight, think!
And if that was Skootaloo that I saw, then, well... I cannot explain what I saw any other way than to say that a Skootaloo purposely broke into my boutique to steal True Blue. What other explanation could there be?
this is going to sound entirely irrelevant, but I think I have a lead on what might have happened to Opalescence. At least, if not True Blue.
Oh, do tell, darling! Although I do admit that I must agree, in that I can't see how this is relevant to what we're discussing here.
I found some white hair right near the tracks outside the window. And judging from their length and color, I don't think there's anyone else they could have come from other than Opalescence. As a result, I think we can reasonably conclude that if those tire marks are from Scootaloo, then it's entirely likely that she crashed through your window completely by accident, not purposefully. She was probably trying to avoid crashing into Opal, which may well have spooked Opal into running away.
Really? But then, that makes things all the more peculiar. Because it is still the fact that she must have stolen True Blue, no?
Let me ask a very important question before answering that. Do you, by any chance, keep your door locked when you go to sleep at night?
Why, yes, of course I do. But I don't see what that has to do with anything.
One follow-up question, then. Do you also bring an opal from outside when you go to bed?
Of course! The poor dear, I couldn't leave her to fend for herself at night.
Then I think we've established something even more important than the accidental break-in.
Twilight, I must ask that you be more direct, as I am not following one word you're saying.
All right, let's think about the facts of the case thus far. We know that you heard a crash and came downstairs to see Scootaloo quickly leaving your boutique. We can reasonably conclude that she probably was responsible for the broken window. However, we also know that the broken window was likely an accident, and that she had veered off course with her scooter because she was avoiding Opal, who was immediately in front of her path. You just told me, though, that you bring in Opal and lock your door at night. So that raises perhaps the most interesting question of all here. Namely, what was Opal doing outside in the first place?
But she would have gotten out when Scootaloo opened the door, would she not?
That's not possible. Think about it. When was it that she veered to avoid Opal?
Right before she crashed through the window. Ah!
I trust you're beginning to see my point. If indeed your door had been locked and had remained that way until Scootaloo left, there would have been no way Opal would have been outside in the first place.
But that would mean that some pony else was in my boutique as well?
Exactly. I think we can reasonably conclude at this point that there at least is the possibility that someone else had entered your boutique before Scootaloo, and that they're the ones who opened the door so that Opal could get out. The question now, though, is who that would be. And that's just what I'm going to find out. Are you still doubting me after all this, Verity?
Well, it's just hard to see you as a detective.
Tell me, who was right about Nightmare Moon?
You, darling, but...
And who solved the mystery of the...
You again, but I really...
And who recognized that Princess Cadence had been replaced by a fake?
Once again, you, but you see...
So, why does no pony ever listen to me?
Well, I suppose it's that, eventually, you must be due for getting something wrong. Wouldn't you agree?
I could explain the many reasons that argument doesn't hold any water, but by the time I even got to Bray's theorem, the Canterlot investigative team would have gotten here and convicted Fluttershy of something like running an illegal bear fighting club. Probably best to drop the subject now, while I have the chance. Sure. That makes sense, I guess. Anyways, I'd best be off. More investigating and such like. Thanks for the help, Rarity.
Anytime, my dear.
Where do I go from here, though? It feels like I've talked to just about every pony. Other than Scootaloo, of course. Wait, Scootaloo? Scootaloo, that's it! I haven't talked to all the Cutie Mark Crusaders yet. And if Applebloom is involved, then the others probably are as well. Now, if I recall correctly, I can get to their clubhouse via the western exit of the town square. It's worth a shot, at any rate.
Twilight, now that I'm thinking about it, I don't believe you've ever joined Fluttershy and me for a trip to the spa. Won't you join us sometime soon?
Oh, well, sure. Just let me see if I can find some room in my schedule. No, that time won't work. I'm meeting with the school's PTA. That one's right out. Mayor wanted me to organize a fall leaf cleanup to go with the running of the leaves and winter wrap-up. This whole week's booked since Princess Celestia wanted me to help organize some of the Cantala archives.
Actually, Twilight, don't worry about it. It's quite all right.
Oh, okay then. Perhaps I need to schedule some free time in there once in a while. Huh? Where's Applebloom? I guess she had to head out or something.
Hey, Twilight! What's up?
Don't startle me like that, Rainbow Dash!
Sorry! So what you up to, Twilight? You're looking all concentrating and stuff.
Haven't you heard? Rarity's prize jewel was stolen last night. And I'm investigating.
Come on, Twilight! Are you sure she didn't just misplace it? And then search high, and then search low, and high and low.
Rainbow Dash, this is serious! Her window was broken in the middle of the night, and the mayor has enlisted the help of a certain investigative team from Canterlot to handle this case!
Did you say the investigation team from Canterlot? You didn't mean the one that tried to drag Derby on charges of Grand Theft Muffin.
That's the one.
You gotta do something, Twilight! They're gonna ruin everything! Again!
I know, Rainbow Dash, I know. But, say, while you're here, I could ask you some questions.
Me? But I don't...
It's for Rarity, Rainbow Dash.
Ugh, fine, whatever.
Well, I guess my biggest question is if you know anything about Scootaloo. Have you seen her lately? Or done anything with her?
I thought it was Rarity who was stolen from. Why are you asking about Scootaloo?
You didn't know? Scootaloo's the prime suspect for the crime.
She's what?!
I'm sure she's innocent, but if you know anything about what's going on with her at all, it'd be a big help. I know she trusts you a lot, so...
Well, no! Can't say I've seen her in, a long time!
Weren't you about to say something?
Me? Nope! Don't know what you're talking about, Twilight!
I have a feeling that unless I present her with something that proves she's recently interacted with Scootaloo, I'm probably not gonna get anywhere here.
Hey, Twilight! Check out these moves I've been practicing to show to the Wonderbolts! Zip-zow-whip! Pretty awesome, huh?
You're not even paying attention to me, are you? Rainbow Dash, I don't suppose you've seen this before, have you?
Nope. Never seen it before in my life.
Do you... know what it is, maybe?
No! Can't say I have any clue, Twilight!
Could you make a guess?
It... looks... like... like something I've never seen before in my life.
How would you even know what that would look like?
Ha!
Seeing that little pipsqueak reminds me of the time she got her little fan club together to see who could make the best sculpture of me.
They, what?
Yup, it was pretty cool, I have to admit. They got all kinds of materials together. Wood, ice, granite, you name it. Now, none of them really quite got my likeness right. But when they were done, they had created a whole lot of wood chips, ice cubes, and train track ballast. All very useful in their own right. I'm mighty proud of them, I gotta say.
Weren't those all just descriptions of broken wood, broken ice, and broken rocks?
You would think that, Twilight, if you were boring!
Oh, right. Of course. Great. It looks like at least one Crusader is here. I don't know where Apple Bloomer, our little suspect, are at the moment, but maybe I can get some information from Sweetie Belle all the same. Hey, Sweetie Belle.
Twilight! Hi! I haven't seen you at our clubhouse in, ever!
Oh, I just thought I'd stop by. How's it going with you three? Have you done any awesome crusading lately?
Oh! Well, no! We're on break!
I'm getting the sense they rehearsed that line. All right, but I really need to ask about... That came from the clubhouse. What's going on in there?
Oh, that's just Applebloom doing something. Something that does not involve Skoodaloo.
Right, of course. All right. Well, I just have a few questions. Sweetie Belle, I happened to see you talking to Applebloom earlier in the town square. I was wondering what you two were talking about. Crusader business, perhaps?
Oh! Well, yeah. I guess you could call it that. As a matter of fact, that's a great thing to call it!
And please tell me that's not all you have to say about it.
Pretty much is! I mean, there isn't really that much more to tell. Skoodaloo's been kinda down.
Well, yes. I'd imagine she has been.
No, no! I mean, extra down! See, she kinda lost something of hers, and it was pretty important to her. She made me promise not to tell any pony. Oops.
Huh. Was there anything I picked up that might fit that bill? She'd probably have lost it when she crashed through the window, whatever it was. I should present it to Sweetie Belle, see if she'll talk any further. Hey, Sweetie Belle. Is this what Skoodaloo lost by any chance?
Oh! Hey! That's it! I mean, that's part of it!
Part of it? What? What is it?
I don't actually know! But I do know it was super duper important to her! It's got this ribbon attachment too! And a short while ago, Skoodaloo came to school wearing it and she looked really proud of it! Unfortunately, that kinda also caught the attention of Diamond Tiara and Silver Spoon, who grabbed it from her and started teasing her with it. Normally, Skoodaloo just gets annoyed at that sort of thing, but that time, I don't think I've ever seen her that upset before. After I helped Applebloom get it back for her, she didn't really want to talk much about it, but she did say something about getting it from Rainbow Dash. We do have the second half of it, though! Just give me 1 second. Here, let me fix it. Skoodaloo's gonna be so excited to get it back. Thanks, Twilight.
Oh, actually, I kinda still need it. It's super important, and it's for Skoodaloo. Do you think I could hold on to it for just a teensy
takes you a bit longer?
Oh, okay. But try to get it back to her before too much longer. She really wanted it back.
I will. Don't worry. Thanks, Sweetie Belle. You've been a big help. All right, Rainbow Dash, you're up. So, about the noise in the clubhouse, I don't suppose I could go in and have a look?
Uh-uh. Sorry, Twilight, but the clubhouse is for official Crusader business only. No adult ponies allowed. Except Applejack, sometimes, since she owns the farm and everything.
Ugh, these fillies, I swear. I don't think I'm getting anywhere right now, though. This swing has always confused me every time I look at it. The design is really weird, to say the least, and not exactly what I'd call practical for ponies. And another thing. As far as I can tell, it violates basic physical laws. When ponies are swinging on these things, there's, well, no upward force at all that would counteract the always-present force of gravity to keep the pony aloft. I'll need to preserve the scene just so, in order to study this in great detail next time I have the opportunity. I have to solve this mystery. Truthful with me.
What are you talking about, Twilight? 100% truthful, right here.
Ugh, no! You are 100% lying. I already heard from Sweetie Belle that you not only know what this is, but also gave it to Scootaloo a short while ago. Ring any bells?
Nope. Never seen that before in my life. Sorry, Twilight. Don't know what Sweetie Belle's talking about. These fillies these days. Am I right?
Rainbow Dash, let me put it this way. This was found at the crime scene. It belongs to Scootaloo. That's all I know, and that's all the investigators from Canterlot are going to know, too. Is that what you want to happen? Please, Rainbow Dash, you know something. I need to know what that is if I'm going to have any hope of clearing Scootaloo's name here. Element of loyalty? You know that thing you are that's supposed to make you stick by your friends and trust them?
Alright! I'll talk! Jeez, I feel like I'm in a mystery novel or something. Yeah, I gave her that ribbon. It was about, I don't know, a week or so ago. I was near the field by the school on weather duty, and Scootaloo was there too. I didn't think much of it, since she was there a lot. It's a nice open area to practice flying. I should know. I practice there a lot, too. Anyways, this time was different. I had already said hi to her, and she didn't say anything. So I flew in closer to see what was going on. Hey, Squirt. Why are you looking all down? You didn't stub your hoof or anything, did ya? Oh, Rainbow Dash. Hey, what's up? You're all... I've been out here every single day because the other ponies at school make fun of me. Because I'm a Pegasus and can't fly. And I really, really want to fly. But I just can't. And I don't know how. And I can't tell Apple Bloom or Sweetie Belle about it. Because they might laugh at me too. Because they're all good at stuff. Not good at stuff, and I don't know what to do. How come I'm the only pony who can't do what she's supposed to be able to do, huh? It's not fair. I mean, sure, she gets down sometimes, but I've never seen her like this, Twilight. I didn't know what to do. Whoa, slow down there, Squirt. What are you... And Man, you're so awesome, and I want to be just like you. But I'm not awesome, and I never will be. Because when you were my age, you already got your cutie mark and helped everybody else. And I haven't done anything. Squirt, I mean, Scootaloo, stop. You don't know what you're talking about, kid. Huh? Alright, look. Wait, right here, kid. I mean it. I'll be right back. I didn't know what in the hoof else to do, so I went back to my home, and then came straight back. And then, well... Here, Squirt. Take it. What's this? A ribbon? Not just any ribbon, Squirt. The ribbon. The ribbon? Ugh, yes, the ribbon. The one and only ribbon I got for winning the race where I got my cutie mark. Wait, you just gave it to her? Well, what else was I supposed to do? I've never seen her that upset, Twilight. I'm not good with fillies. Whoa. And I can have this? On one condition, Squirt. You gotta treat it right. There's a story behind that ribbon, you know. That's not just a ribbon. It represents drive. It represents guts. It represents a don't give upness that everybody should have. But most of all, it represents courage. The courage to stick up for you and your friends. A courage to not be afraid of stupid bullies. The courage to do something really super daring for you and your friends. You wanna fly, kid? You wanna earn a cutie mark? That's how you do it. So yeah, you can have this. If you promise to trust your friends and not to think they're gonna make fun of you. Cause I can tell you right now that no real friends of yours would do that. Got that, Squirt? Wow! Thanks, Rainbow Dash! You're the coolest ever!
That is pretty cool. I'm impressed. But wait, why didn't you want to tell me this?
Ugh, you wouldn't understand, Twilight. I've got an image. I've got style. I've got awesomeness. Coolness. Radicalness. That kind of sappy thing? Totally unawesome. You gotta promise to never, ever, ever tell any pony, Twilight. My life will be ruined.
Well, all right, Rainbow Dash. But I think there's one filly who sure thought that was awesome.
Yeah, yeah. Anyways, I...
Did that all really happen? Did it? Did it? Huh? Huh?
Yeah. Apple Bloom, how long have you been standing there?
Forget that! How much did you hear?
Oh, I heard all of it. Lance said Scootaloo's always talked about you. But I never thought you'd do something like that! I can't wait to tell Sweetie Belle about it!
No! Can't tell any pony! You can't!
Say, we're supposed to do a show and tell thing at school in a couple days. This'll be perfect! Why, we'll have the best show and tell ever!
Right, I'm doomed.
What are you doing here anyways, Apple Bloom?
Well, I was looking for you. See, that ribbon you got? Scootaloo kinda sorta really, really wants it back, and well, Sweetie Belle said you had it. So...
All right. On one condition, though. I think it's about time I talked to Scootaloo about all this. How about you and I deliver this ribbon together?
Well, I would, but I promised Scootaloo I wouldn't let any pony who wasn't a crusader into the clubhouse. No exceptions!
Oh, so she is in the clubhouse then.
See? Old pony feathers! I did it again, didn't I?
Come on, Apple Bloom. I can't clear her name without talking to her about this. She has information I need to know and I need to hear it from her.
All right. I guess I could make you an honorary cutie mark crusader for today. Then I won't be breaking my promise.
It's a deal.
Only for today, though. Hey! Look, he's got... got a partner, Miss Partner Haver.
Pinky? I don't even know why you surprise me anymore.
Oh, is there a surprise? Where's the surprise? I love surprises!
Anyway, weren't you going to talk about partners?
Oh, yeah! You've got a partner now, and that's just super-dee-duper-ific!
She's just walking me to the clubhouse.
Of course she is! Once a pony's your partner, they'll walk with you everywhere! They're like your new bestest best friend! Partners also sometimes have active abilities that let you do things either in the field or during conversations. But Apple Bloom's just a little filly, so she can't do that yet. We'll have to talk about that part later. Hey, I'm a big pony! Well, duh! You just haven't found what your super special partner talent is yet. Kinda like a cutie mark.
Thank you, Professor Pinkie Pie.
No problem. Aw, you two look so cute together already. Have fun, Twilight!
So, about that honorary cutie mark crusadership.
No!
You're sure? I'd love to study what goes into cutie mark crusading for science.
No means no, Twi. I can't jeopardize the integrity of our outfits. Not even for Rand. I'm sorry, Twi.
Sheesh. So serious all of a sudden. All right. Let's just get to the clubhouse.
All right, Twi.
In the clubhouse. I don't suppose I could go in and have a look?
Sorry, Twilight, but the clubhouse is for official Crusader business only. No adult ponies allowed. Except Applejack, sometimes, since she owns the farm and everything.
Applebloom, help me out here.
Oh, it's all right, Sweetie Belle. I've made Twi here an honorary cutie mark crusader for today.
But
she has a cutie mark. I know! That's what makes her honorary! Duh! Oh! Okay then! Welcome to our clubhouse, honorary cutie mark crusader!
Thanks, Sweetie Belle.
Applebloom! I thought I told you not to let any non-crusaders in here!
Oh, don't you worry about that, Scootaloo. I made Twi here an honorary crusader for today.
You what? Ugh, Applebloom, that's not something you just do on your own.
Oh, but she found your ribbon. Ain't it worth something?
She did? Really?
Yes, I did.
Oh, give it here!
Hold your horses there, Scootaloo. First, I have a few things to ask about, if I may.
Ugh, really, Twilight?
You want this ribbon back, right?
Fine, make it quick!
Scootaloo, I have to ask you about last night.
Oh, last night?
Yes, last night. Or, more specifically, where you were last night.
I don't know what you're talking about, Twilight.
Oh, I think you do, Scootaloo. I've already talked to Applebloom about some of it.
Applebloom? What? What did she say, Twilight?
I know that you three were around Town Square. So, perhaps we should start there.
Is everything alright, Twilight?
Well, yes. It's just that right around here is usually when...
Hi!
Right on schedule.
Oh my gosh, Twilight, this is exciting! You finally come across a confrontation!
Uh-huh.
Now, these are a whole lot like interrogations, except they're longer and cooler! This time, when you totally present some evidence and show that pony who's boss, they may just keep on coming. They're not gonna give in right away. That wouldn't be any fun.
Oh no, it'd be so terrible if some pony around here actually just told me something.
Basically, you're gonna soon enough see multiple topics, and you gotta bring each of them to a conclusion before you finally get to the bottom of things! Kind of like how you gotta get to the middle of a jelly donut to get to the sweet thing filling!
Well, I can do that.
But uh-oh, here's a part that might be all frowny wowny. If you present the wrong evidence too many times, well, it's all over, Buster! That pony's never gonna tell you anything!
But... wait, what? What do I do then?
Oh! Well, then you just start over.
Start over?
Well, yeah! You just select try again from the screen, and the confrontation will start back over like nothing ever happened!
Pinky, I don't think conversations work that way.
Like she doesn't even know this is a video game. Well, good luck! I'm rooting for you!
Is she always like that?
Yes. Yes, she is.
Oh, one other thing! You also can't leave or save the game once a confrontation starts.
Wait, what?
But don't worry! You can't start them when you don't have everything you need. Super convenient, right?
Everything I need for this? Well, that's a start, I guess. But now it's time to put everything together. Anyways, Scootaloo, about last night and your comedy routine.
It was supposed to be a secret!
But yeah, we've been working on a comedy routine for Rarity's birthday. I imagine you already heard that much from Apple Blabbermouth.
Just a minute. Hey, I didn't tell her right away, Scootaloo. She used, like, her big detective brain on me. I didn't stand a chance.
I have no idea if that was a compliment or sarcasm. So, I'll take it as the former. Out of curiosity, why Rarity's birthday? I can see you doing something like this for Cheerilee, but this is different.
Sweetie Belle's idea. She wanted to do something for her sister and somehow roped us into this. I told her that under no circumstances were we going to do something all touchy-feely for Rarity, so that was kind of a compromise. We haven't done comedy in a while, so it seemed like an okay idea to me.
All right. Well, when were you practicing this comedy routine?
We started pretty late in the evening around Town Square, so we could be there when there weren't any ponies around. After we got started, we got into our routine pretty heavily. Heck, we were working on it non-stop until we called it a night.
Wait a second. Not entirely non-stop, I'm afraid.
Huh?
I happen to know that you three took a break part of the way through your practice session. And I also happen to know that neither Applebloom nor Sweetie Belle knew where you were during that time.
Applebloom!
Sorry, Scootaloo.
Well, what about it?
Huh?
Maybe we did take a break and I went off somewhere else. What about it? Doesn't mean anything. It's not like you know where I was.
How's this? Actually, I think I have a pretty good idea of where you were.
What? How?
I talked to Rarity earlier and learned that she witnessed an orange and purple pony running out the door after she discovered her home had been ransacked and her prize jewel stolen. And I also found part of this ribbon just outside the window to her boutique. Not to mention there were tire tracks that looked suspiciously like your scooters, leading directly to that window. sounding familiar yet, Scootaloo?
Well, actually, no! Can't say it is!
What?
Come on, Twilight! None of that points to me! Listen to yourself! I jumped through a window to break in? I mean, that's gonna hurt! Not to mention make a lot of noise! And why in the world would I steal anything from some pony whose sister I'm friends with? That makes no sense! All you've got is circumstantial evidence!
I don't know whether to be annoyed by her stubbornness or impressed by the fact that she correctly used the phrase circumstantial evidence in a sentence. Stay cool, Twilight. You already know what you need here. You just need to find ways to prove it to her.
Honestly, Twilight, I can't believe this! You're accusing me of stealing from my best friend's sister? What's gotten into you?
Just a minute. Scootaloo, I'm not accusing you of anything. I'm simply stating facts. Please, calm down and trust me on this.
I'm not gonna calm down when you're talking like this! Give me a break, Twilight! Give me one good reason why I'd steal from her. No, not even just from her. From any pony!
Wait, Sucker. Alright.
Alright what?
I can, in fact, provide a motive for why you'd want to steal Rarity's prize jewel.
Uh-huh.
Scootaloo, I know that a short while ago, Rainbow Dash gave you a very special ribbon of hers and told you a few choice words. Among those, however, was the instruction that you should do something very daring for you and your friends. I trust you know where I'm going with this. If you really did do a bold heist of Rarity's boutique in the middle of the night to steal her most precious jewel, that would certainly be awfully daring.
What? No, Twilight, no! You got it all wrong! That wasn't it at all! After she said that, I started practicing scooter tricks, not theft! Stealing things from ponies is so uncool, Twilight! I never! You remember those tricks that Rainbow Dash did at the Best Young Flyer competition, right? I had to try one of those out! Of course I can't fly, so, well, I kinda had to make do with what I can do. You remember that trick where she spun clouds around, right? So awesome! Well, not as awesome as the Sonic Rain Boom, of course, but I figured, you know, maybe I'd work up to that. The carousel boutique's nice and round, so I've been practicing going around it at top speed. I'm getting pretty good at it. Anyway, the point is, that was not what I had in mind when she gave me that advice. At all.
All right, Scootaloo. I believe you.
Come on, Twilight! Even you have to admit that the story you're telling here sounds awfully far-fetched. First, there's the window itself. I mean, really, Twilight? You're going to claim that I rolled directly towards the window and crashed through it? Why in the hoop would I do that?
Wait, Sucker. No. Actually, I'm not gonna claim that you rode directly towards the window, because that's not what happened.
Well, then what?
You said it yourself. You've been practicing going around the Carousel Boutique at top speed, right?
Yeah.
What do you think might happen if, say, Opalescence were to suddenly be in the way? We did find her hair near the tire marks, after all. You'd have to swerve pretty hard to avoid hitting her, right? Hard enough that you might leave tire marks and lose control of your scooter. And then perhaps crash and be launched accidentally through the window of her boutique. Am I getting warm, Scootaloo?
Bingo! Bullseye! Can't get warmer than that! Enough already! I give!
Do you think, now, you might be willing to finally tell me what happened that night?
Apple Bloom?
Well, I can help you, Scootaloo. I can just feel it.
All right. No more running, hiding, or dodging. I'll just give it to you straight. Not much else to do now, right? You already know most of it, so, well, I won't bore you with those details. Yeah, I was practicing that trick. Opa got in front of me. I tried to avoid her, and wham! Before I knew it, I was flying through that window.
I guess the star from my ribbon got caught on something and was torn off when I did. Honestly, I didn't see much when I was there. I saw some dark figures who I think got startled when I crashed through the window. They ran away pretty quickly after I did. I heard one of them trip, at which point I heard a pretty scary growl and a yell, as well as the sound of, something getting ripped. By a claw, I guess? It didn't take me long to figure out what was going on and that I needed to get the heck out of here, so I ran as quickly as I could. And, that's about it, really. I totally forgot about the scooter when I left since I was in such a panic, so I came back and got it later.
I hadn't actually thought about what happened to your scooter until just now. Any reason you bring that up?
It's strange, Twilight. I feel like there are thousands of ponies somewhere out there, watching us, looking closely for missing information, and judging us harshly if they find any.
That's oddly specific.
Call it a Philly's instinct.
Well, thanks, Scootaloo. I think it's about time I paid the Carousel Boutique a second look. Oh, and before I forget, here's your ribbon back. Sorry to have used it as a bit of a bargaining chip.
Yay!
Guessing that Scootaloo did most of the interior decorating of this clubhouse?
Actually, no, I did. Well, Scootaloo does host weekly meetings for the Rainbow Dash Fan Club.
And these pictures are the results of an art contest I hosted. Aren't they awesome, Twilight? The best pictures ever? Huh?
Yes. Just like the other couple dozen of them you've shown me in the past. In rapid succession. Sheesh, I didn't know there were that many poses you could even put one pony in. Oh hey, new copies of the full free press. How has that been going, now that, Diamond Tiara isn't in charge of it anymore?
To be honest, why, not many ponies read the school newspaper anymore.
Yeah! Featherweight was always better at taking pictures anyway. I can't believe Miss Cheerily put him in charge.
Really? What's wrong with it?
Twi, just read the cover stories and you'll see what I mean.
Mr. Waddles went to the store today. This is, news? And how in Equestria did you write an entire article on this?
The same way I did when I wrote the Cutie Mark Crusader speech. A sleepless night and a big thesaurus to find lots of awesome big words to use. Not bad, don't you think, Twilight?
Mr. Waddle's extemporaneous, vindictive, superlative, mollify, intransigence. Scootaloo, this isn't even a sentence. It's just several large words strung together.
Yeah, it's not my best work. But I have better things to do than write boring stories for the school newspaper.
Dedication is not your middle name, I'm guessing. Who's this? I don't remember you hanging out with this pony before.
Twilight, I would think that that was obvious.
Oh, well, in that case, is it Sunbloom from school?
No.
Berry Pinch?
No.
Captain Cloudy?
No! Come on, Twilight, you're not even trying!
What? No! I swear I am! I just don't know who it is.
It's Winona, Twilight! Winona!
Sweetie Belle, by any chance were you the painter?
Yep, Verity was super proud of me.
I see the resemblance. No, wait. Nope. Still nothing. Oh, hey, paintbrushes. What are these for?
Duh,
full paint and stuff.
All three of us love arts and crafts while we are in school, so why not continue that at our weekly meetings?
What sort of things do you make with them?
Anything we need for our adventures. You name them, we probably have painted them.
We painted vehicles, hang gliders, props, fireworks, giant greeting cards, live animals, and a bunch of other cool stuff.
Back up there. Live animals?
Yeah! We saw how cool the painted animals at the circus looked, and we wanted to try our hooves at painting some.
We tried our luck with some cows and chickens on the farm, but Applejack got pretty angry at us the next morning since Aunt and Uncle Orange came to visit. Still, the looks on the orange faces were too funny.
That creates so many questions in my mind that I really think it would be best to leave it there and not ask any of them.
Dreadful, awful mess. Just a few more bits and pieces to put in order, and it'll be good as new.
But it's a crime scene.
I know. Wasn't it terrible? It's taken me all morning to get it back to near working condition.
Rarity, you don't just clean up a crime scene. You need to leave the mess is so we can find evidence implicating the culprit. All the mystery novels are completely unanimous on this.
I suppose that would make sense.
Ugh, forget it. Let's see if there's anything of note left. Well, this is something at least. I suppose. This stool wasn't like this yesterday, right?
I should say not! I certainly would have cleaned that up if it had been. Like I was about to.
Down, Rarity. Resist the urge. Let it be dirty for one day.
If you insist, I shall do my best.
But I don't see anything else. Is there really nothing left to look at in here? No offense, but this stool isn't going to do much.
Well, if you've overlooked anything, I might be able to help with that.
Really? How?
Recall that gem-finding spell that I taught you a little while ago, Twilight? Well, I just so happen to have been improving it to find other things that are easily overlooked. I tell you, Twilight, that has been invaluable keeping everything in good working condition around the boutique. I used to spend so long finding all the little things I work with around here.
Huh. Well, that does sound useful. Okay, let's try it out. How does it...
Are you girls talking about Rarity's super duper looper hooper cool ability? I've been waiting so long to talk about it.
Silly me. I thought I might actually get a tutorial from some pony who knows something about the topic at hand.
You know those crazy times when you're making cupcakes, but then you totally can't figure out where you left the egg timer? Nope. Well, I sure have, and let me tell you, they are not fun, Buster. But Rarity never has those problems. Because once she turns on that super special power of hers, then she can kind of just point her horn and poof! Anything nearby lights up like a disco ball. Then you just gotta go over and take an itty-bitty look-see.
If you ask for extra help from the options menu, then the button will light up all brighty like to let you know there's something important to find. Ooh, sparkly!
I still don't...
I know. Trust me, Twilight. They understand me.
Uh-huh.
Come on, why don't you try it out? I bet there's a little something over to the left of that stool. Okie dokie, hope you find lots of cool treasure out there. Bye!
Inaccurate, albeit perhaps over-enthusiastic description.
Well, let's get to it. There must be something around here, right?
My dear, I'm sure we'll find something around here if we use that spell of mine.
But wait, why are you telling me? You're the one doing it.
She really doesn't get it, does she?
Alas, no. It would seem not.
Why does every pony always seem to get her but me? Say, Rarity. I know that these boots are here for trying on dresses, but I've always wondered, what's the purpose of the drawers?
Why, darling, accessories, of course! A dress isn't a dress without a little sprucing up to match the pony who's going to wear it! Let's see, we've got gems, jewels, sequins, lace, buttons, threads, frills, bells, patches, little pieces of string that I've picked up off the ground, fuzzy bits that I'm not sure what they're from.
I think I'm getting the picture, Rarity. Thanks. Although, aren't gems and jewels the same thing?
Certainly not! Only an untrained eye would think such a thing! That is, not to say that you're, untrained in terms of optical ability, Twilight.
Gee, thanks. This. This is an oddly shaped jewel. Seen this before?
No, I can't say I have.
Strange. Small gems? Rarity, did the thieves try to steal these too?
Well, no, actually. Those had been on that stool. I imagine they were knocked over with it. I had been trying to find them, though. Thank you, Twilight.
Never mind then. Well, now I think that's about it for things to be found in here. Thanks, Rarity. Say, I wonder if we missed anything else somewhere else. Rarity, would you mind tagging along a little longer? That ability looks useful.
But of course, Twilight! Lead the way, my dear!
I should check elsewhere to see if we've missed anything. Perhaps outside the boutique to start. You certainly take good care of your mirrors. These practically shine.
But of course, it's how I size up all of my clients. You can't see clearly if you can't first see clearly, you know?
Yeah. I think...
Now that I look at you in this light, why, you're looking positively radiant, darling!
I am?
But of course! Picture it! I could put together a nice green dress for you! No, not green, sea green! And it would be flowing and would have sapphires from the hip down to the bottom in a swirling fashion!
Rarity...
But it would have to have the shoulders just right. Why, if they're too small, then it's like they aren't there at all. But if they're too big, well, then you look just like a cliché tacky princess. Nothing like the princesses we know.
Rarity.
And of course we have to give you something else to wear on top of your back. Why, it just wouldn't do to make there be nothing separate. Now I'm thinking of something silk. Maybe orange? Or perhaps, yes, of course, something red. My dear, to accentuate that rather tasteful streak you have in your mane, and...
Rarity!
Oh, yes, Twilight?
Perhaps we should be getting back to our investigation?
But I'm in the zone, Twilight! You could be the star inspiration for my entire new fashion lineup!
Rarity, investigation.
Alright, alright.
Had come in through the second floor window.
Twilight, that is my bedroom. I rather think I would have noticed if they had come in through there.
Right. Never mind. What's this? A hairpin, if I'm not mistaken. Ha! This is conclusive evidence on multiple levels. First, we most certainly have never seen Scootaloo use a hairpin. So we know this cannot be from her. Furthermore, if this is indeed not hers, then it must be from the thief. There's no other option. Therefore, we also know that the culprit is likely a female who uses hairpins. Ha! Score one for Investigator Twilight.
Twilight, could I see that for a second?
Of course. Do you see anything else that may be deduced?
Well, no. But I do believe that this is the hairpin I lost yesterday. Thank you, Twilight.
Right. Well, I suppose that's, another option, too. Ha! I knew there was no way that Scootaloo wouldn't have had enough forethought to break through this window if she were trying to steal a jewel. Instead, she just didn't have enough forethought to avoid crashing through this window when Opal jumped in her path. I'm not sure if that came out right. Trampled in this area, like some pony ran through here. Ordinarily, that wouldn't be remarkable, considering that thieves naturally would trample the grass as they left, but there's something that strikes me as odd about this. The thing that's odd about this trampled grass is... Wait a second. What was it that Apple Bloom said about what she saw?
And then a while after that, some pony ran across the bridge real fast. We didn't get a good look at it, but I'm pretty sure it was Scootaloo, Twi.
Scootaloo went across the bridge. Yet this trampled grass rather clearly does not lead towards the bridge. I think it's safe to say this adds even more credibility to the idea that some pony had been here before Scootaloo. The question now is, who? Was it another pony? No, that seems unlikely. A pony wouldn't have left behind this piece of evidence. know they left behind a mark that ponies wouldn't easily make. Who was at the boutique last night? Was it another pony? No, that seems unlikely. How's this? That stool was ripped up by what seems clearly a claw. But ponies sure don't have claws. Someone who would steal a jewel and who has claws. I'm starting to get a picture here. There it is. I think I may have deduced something.
Truly, Twilight? Fantastic! Do tell!
It's only an educated guess right now. But it might lead to something bigger than that. Follow me. I think I can get where I need to go from the south entrance of town square. Time to pay an old friend a little visit.
Twilight, one must allow a lady to handle a situation with such a fine gentle colt. Dog, whatever. Ahem, dearest, dog, we would be ever so grateful if you would allow us entry.
No.
Oh, come now. Surely we can, work things out. If you get my drift.
No.
No? Is that it? You're quite sure?
Yes.
Well, I never! You shall stand aside, my good dog, right this instant!
No.
You, sir, are a ruffian and a cur! And I have half a mind to find whoever is responsible for such a clearly insufficient upbringing and rearing and give that individual a rather significant piece of my mind! Are we quite clear on this matter?
Yes.
And furthermore, I dare say that I might just report this behavior to... Oh, whichever officials are tasked with regulating this sort of thing, because let me tell you!
What in the seventh dog stands is this ridiculous law? Not you! What are you here for?
You!
If I could interject for just a little bit...
you!
Sheesh. I see those two get along about as well as they did before. Now, if we're all done being little kids, Mr. Dog? My name is Twilight Sparkle. I'm investigating a crime that happened last night, and I have reason to suspect that someone from here might be involved. Could we take a look around your, caverns?
No.
No?
No.
I guess now we know who trains the guards around here. Mr. Dog, if you don't let us in, then I'm going to have to...
I wouldn't do that, Pony.
Excuse me?
Do not have warrant. No warrant, no entry. You enter, you trespass.
When in Equestria did the Diamond Dogs get all weak?
I'm afraid they are. Right. Much as it pains me to admit that, things have changed between ponies and dogs since we made, first contact, I suppose you could call it.
Why am I always the last to know this sort of thing?
You see, we have a bit of an agreement. They abide by our laws, and we leave them alone. Which means that I'm afraid we indeed cannot simply barge in like hooligans. Much as I would like to.
Okay, and how do we get around this exactly?
A warrant, my dear. Like you said, if we show the mayor reason for suspicion, then she can issue a search warrant to allow us entry. Simple, really.
Simple, right. Famous last words, Rarity. Alright, well, don't go anywhere. We'll be back.
We are not moving anywhere, unlike you. You go away now.
Alright, well, the mayor's going to be working at Town Hall this time of day, so back to Town Square. Nowhere else to go right now. Some important work. I'll wait until she's done.
Yes. I think our budget can manage if we're more efficient in this area, allowing us to free up enough bids from those savings. I really have to make sure the catering service is on time this time. We can't have a repeat of last year's debacle. Yes, that should do it. Planning birthdays is hard work. I do hope Mother appreciates all this.
Silly me. I was thinking of a different mayor who actually takes responsibility seriously.
Oh, Twilight Sparkle. I didn't hear you come in. Can I help you with anything? Ah, our old equestrian flag. Put in place over 1,000 years ago to celebrate our 2 reigning princesses. Although... until Princess Luna returned, I never did understand the second half of the flag. I always thought that perhaps Princess Celestia had dumped herself in blackberry jam or something like that. I hear that's the newest rage among the young ponies, after all.
I don't even know how one would respond to that, so I won't. A comprehensive equestrian history, equestrian law, advanced mathematics on the nature of existence. Wow, Mayor, I'm impressed. This is some heavy reading.
Why, thank you, Twilight.
Which did you read last? Wow, I remember all of these books.
Oh, I never read them. I just thought they looked nice.
Right, of course you did. Huh? Wow, it looks like the Mayor's really been working hard on something. Let's see here. My autobiography, chapter 1. I was born to a meager Ponyville family. A Mayor's Life, chapter 1. Tale of a Mayor, chapter 1. Yeah, I guess I should have seen that one coming.
What do you girls think? I just commissioned some ponies to come up with a flag for Ponyville, and there you have it. Doesn't it look wonderful? Can't you just feel the majestic history emanating from it?
Well, the green on red is a bit festive, and the outline is a bit plain, wouldn't you say? I mean, the interior is interesting enough, perhaps, but all this green, darling, it's just empty space. Unused empty space.
I paid a fortune's worth of bids to that artistic team.
Oh, well, it's nice.
So many bids.
I think we should change the subject before she goes catatonic on us.
Twilight, my dear, what is it? We need to speak to the mayor, do we not?
Well, yes, I just wanted to see if you had thought of a better idea. Forget it. Let's just head to town hall. Mayor, we need your help with something. We have reason to suspect that the Diamond Dogs were involved with the crime against Rarity last night. And we need a search warrant to let us search their caverns. Did I do that right?
Twilight, to begin, what evidence do you have that this is the case?
Well, a ripped stool in the Carousel Boutique, and trampled grass outside the Carousel Boutique.
And this implicates the Diamond Dogs. How?
I guess it doesn't really, does it? Sheesh. I liked the mayor back when she seemed incompetent.
Even if you had evidence, Twilight, that brings us to the second point. You aren't acting in any official capacity. I can't very well just give a search warrant to any ordinary citizen.
But we don't have any pony like that.
Well, yes. Hence the reason why we're bringing in a team from Canterlot, honestly. Twilight, it would do you some good to pay attention.
Well, we can address the issue that I'm not an investigator later. Right now, we need to fix the evidence problem. Because she's right. I don't have solid evidence that would cast suspicion on the Diamond Dogs.
I don't believe there was much else around the boutique. Perhaps we should go back to the cabin entrance and see if we can find anything there?
No better ideas over here. Let's go.
Oh, Twilight! That reminds me. I heard some rather wonderful news from the investigative team in Canterlot.
Oh, really? Were they delayed? Please say they were delayed. I need more time!
I'm pleased to report that they wrapped up their current case earlier than expected, and will be here tomorrow instead of a few days' time. Isn't that great?
Oh, tomorrow? That's great! Rarity, let's go, like, right now! We have a case to solve!
Is she all right?
I'm sure she'll be fine. Eventually.
look the same. That's almost certainly Opal's hair on a dog's back. Interesting. Well, I think I have about all the evidence I can get to convince the mayor of the Diamond Dog's involvement. I sure hope this works. I should get back to Town Hall.
Twilight, I'm very busy right now. I can't be bothered with something like that.
How many birthdays do you have to plan for exactly? Mayor, I hate to say it, but I can't find any decent evidence casting suspicion on the Diamond Dogs for the theft of the True Blue. However, I do have evidence casting suspicion on them for a different crime.
And what would that be?
The True Blue wasn't the only thing stolen last night. Opalescence was also stolen as well. And I have reason to suspect that it was the Diamond Dogs who did it.
This is a serious accusation, Twilight. What evidence do you have?
We found hair just like this on the back of one of the Diamond Dogs. It's Opal's. It has to be.
It has to be. Why?
Ugh, come on! What other animal has hair like this, Mare?
I don't know, but really, Twilight, this is Equestria. Our judicial system is based on innocent until proven guilty. It is your job to prove something, not that of the accused. If you don't have anything that actually relates to Opal, I don't think I can do anything here, I'm afraid.
Now I really miss when the mayor seemed incompetent. All right, back to the investigation. All right, Mayor. You wanted more evidence? I've got more evidence. We found this ribbon, which is Opal's, right outside the Diamond Dog's caverns. Between that and the hair on the Diamond Dog's back, don't you think it's at least reasonable to suspect the Diamond Dogs of having a part in Opal's disappearance?
All right, Twilight. I suppose you have a point. I will grant that by this point in time, you have certainly established reasonable suspicion of the Diamond Dogs. However...
What now?
There is still the issue, Twilight, that you are not an investigator.
Right. That.
Twilight, the team from Canterlot will be here soon enough. Why are you doing all of this?
Because they couldn't solve their way out of a paper bag. This is serious business, and if they get involved and take over, there's no way we'll get to the bottom of this. There must be something you can do.
If I may interject, Mayor? By this time, Twilight has already rung the truth, to use a base expression, out of several ponies already, and has found and learned a great deal about this case. I had my doubts, but if my word counts for anything around Ponyville, I, for one, now have complete confidence in Twilight Sparkle's investigative abilities.
Well, I suppose if we do not have a police force in Ponyville, that would make me the closest thing Ponyville has to such a thing. It's rather unorthodox, but if you absolutely will not let this go, then I suppose I could use my position as mayor of Ponyville to make you an official Ponyville investigator. Temporarily, at least.
You... really?
Twilight Sparkle, by the power vested in me as mayor of Ponyville, I hereby offer you the, temporary of course, position of official Ponyville investigator, and all the responsibilities and duties expected therein. Do you accept this position?
Oh, to heck with it. Yes! Which is to say, I, accept.
Just don't make me regret this, Twilight.
You won't, Mare. I promise. All right, Diamond Dogs. Your time is up. back to the caverns. Not this time. I have your precious search warrant right here.
What? Give me that! Pony, tell me you are not seriously accusing us dogs of kidnapping!
I most certainly am. Move aside. I'm coming in.
Fine, fine. You will search what you must for catnapping, and then you will leave! Quickly!
Opal! Opal! Mama's here to rescue you! Where are you?
Rarity, I don't think she's just going to come when you call.
But these caverns are so expensive! And it's all dank in here! It's going to ruin my mane!
Get the search over with and move! Yes!
Wall is loose. Let's see if there's anything behind it. Aha! There's a safe behind it. Let's have a look at it. Just a simple keyhole. Nothing too complex. I imagine one of the dogs has the key.
Nothing to say to the pony.
If you don't cooperate...
Nothing happens, as we have the right not to talk to you.
Right. I was just testing you. Culprits who know their rights are so infuriating. Furniture looks like it's been carved right out of gems. I guess that makes sense. If that's what's available, that's what you use. Not that I want to give the Diamond Dogs any credit for anything, but the This is quite fascinating. I've never seen anything like it. Huh? This furniture looks like it's been carved right out of gems. I guess that makes sense. If that's what's available, that's what you use. Not that I want to give the diamond...
Now this is peculiar. Last I was here, the dogs dug just using their claws. I wonder what these are for.
Maybe they got tired of that.
Darling, the floor is dirt and the walls are dusty rock. I dare say a dog would not mind a little grime in his claws.
Then, what would this be for?
Well, I haven't a clue about that, my dear. Perhaps carving rocks for sculpture.
Rarity, only you could arrive at the conclusion that a shovel and crowbar are more likely to be used for fine art than for practical matters, and then manage to make it sound plausible.
Ugh! Eek! How do these dogs stay safe when they all wear the same style of clothing? I mean, in Canterlot, if even two ponies are caught wearing the same dress, that would be a major faux pas, let alone every pony! After all this is done, I shall simply have to start a line of diamond dogwear. There's nothing for it. I must!
Rarity, call me crazy, but I don't think that the dogs, care.
Don't be upset, darling. Dogs work the same as every pony. All one must do is make them feel terrible about the way they dress, and they'll buy anything you're offering.
Very business savvy, and delightfully cynical, too. Aside from some patches where it looks like furniture used to be. What's this about? Did someone live here? Strange. Inside it, huh?
Nothing you need to concern yourself with, pony!
Grr! I have a search warrant! You will open it for me!
Your search warrant is for a cat, not a safe!
Ugh! Why must all these dogs know their rights? It's not fair!
Unless you have something that ties us to your stupid cat! Proves nothing, Pony! No connection, no looking and
seeing! Right! You could at least be nice about it. Sheesh.
Unless you have something that...
How's this? As a matter of fact, yes. I found this white hair, clearly from the cat in question, in the dirt next to the sink.
Fine! Fine! Whatever! Not like there's anything to see anyway! See? Nothing.
What? Huh? It is empty. Why didn't you want to show me this?
Because you are an extremely annoying pony!
Patience, Twilight. Patience. Can I at least, have that key to look at? It's very important.
Yeah! Fine! Take it!
Way to go, Twilight! You totally saved face there! I bet they don't even suspect that I have no idea what I'm doing. That's it. I feel like I found all that I'm going to in these caverns, but this still isn't enough.
Well, there is... one other possible place to search, darling.
Really? Where? Where?
You could always have a look around the place where I initially found True Blue. I haven't the slightest idea if you'll find much, but it might be worth a look, no? It's just down the road from the fork we took to get to these caverns.
Well, all right. Let's go then.
We shan't be bested by these ruffians! Come on, let's search where I found the True Blue!
Right, onward! Gems and different states of wear. But my hunch was right. These two keys are otherwise identical, which means that this key almost certainly opens that safe as well. I'm beginning to get a hunch regarding what's going on here, but that's for later.
Hmm.
the spot, so to speak. And if we suppose that these claw marks indicate that whoever was here was frantically digging, then those would seem to go together. Namely, they indicate that whoever was digging here was expecting to find something, and in all likelihood, didn't find it. Very interesting. All right, I think the picture is starting to become clear to me.
It is. I must confess that I can't quite know what you mean, my dear.
Don't worry, Rarity. I think it's just about time we cleared Scootaloo's name once and for all. Let's head back and have one last chat with that leader dog.
Present evidence. The pony does not even know how to present evidence. Perhaps the pony is getting ahead of herself.
These dogs and their legal wit, where does it come from? Have they been stealing books from my library too? Ahem. I am an investigator, and you will talk about last night. Please?
No.
Why?
The pony is here to find a cat, not to talk about gems.
He's right. But surely you'd still like to, establish your innocence, right?
Fine. We do not even know what the pony wants us to say. The pony has produced no evidence that would place us at the crime scene. Thousands of ponies are in your little Ponyville. Why not them?
Wait, Sephora. All right, you want evidence? I've got some evidence.
The pony is becoming boring.
Just ignore them, Twilight. Just ignore them. If you're done ignoring me, I have just one important question. Do ponies have claws anywhere?
No.
Then perhaps you might want to explain how this stool in Rarity's boutique became ripped last night after the thief tripped over it! A creature that has claws and would want a huge sparkling gem? That seems to narrow it down a bit, don't you think? Did I get them?
Goodness sake! The pony is covering Vern for the obvious other suspect!
Of course. It's never that easy.
You mangy mongrels! Are you telling me that you're about to accuse some holy innocent pony?
Accuse pony? Yes! Accuse innocent pony? No!
But the pony will please refrain from whining all the same.
Calm down, Rarity. Let's hear it, dogs. I can't say I like where this is going. If they've got another suspect in mind, then I'd better do whatever I can to prove that it couldn't be whomever they've got in mind. Now's no time to lose your head, though, Twilight. Let's hear what they've got to say.
Please, the pony is obviously covering for someone who she doesn't want anyone to suspect here. We refer, of course, to your little dragon friend.
Just a minute. Dragon? You mean Spike? How in the world do you conclude he did it?
I'm getting to that! The pony will be silent and let me finish! He has claws and a healthy appetite for gems! Gems just like the one pilfered from your prissy pony! What happened? Here's what happened! Your little dragon friend broke the window to your pony's house, then jumped in! He's not the brightest, so of course he wouldn't have cared about the noise! Once inside, he found the gem and made off with it like the dirty little thief he is! We already know he has rampaging greedy little episodes! Gems stolen, houses destroyed, this is no different from that! I believe the pony is now aware of just how off-base she really is! Go away!
Just a minute. No, I don't realize.
How dare you! Insulting my dear Twilight and my precious little Spiky Wikey in one breath? You gods truly do not understand how to treat a lady.
I did it!
And that's another thing. You still have yet to take regular baths, as far as my nose can tell. And my goodness, you'd think that you could invent proper ventilation, or have at least something approaching modern civilization.
Stop whining!
Must we retread this old ground? I am not!
Shut up!
Rarity? I don't think this is getting us anywhere.
Perhaps, my dear, but it was oh so worth it.
Dragon friend? I can't believe they'd bring up Spike. This is absurd. But he does have claws. And he did have that massive surge of greed.
No, Twilight. Of course he didn't do it. But how do I prove that? What shows he couldn't be the culprit? Think, Twilight. Think. Spike's depending on you.
Wait.
Spike couldn't have been the culprit.
What? How?
I don't know.
Stop guessing! Sheesh!
Right on the money.
He has claws and...
is no different from Spike's rampage, huh?
Ah, what? No! No! It was no different than that stupid little dragon's stupid little outburst!
No different at all?
No! Not one bit!
Really? Then, would you care to explain one little thing?
What?
Why was the True Blue the only thing that was stolen?
What's this a pony on about now?
When Spike was all Spike want, he stole everything in sight. It didn't matter what it was, he wanted it. But in this case, nothing was stolen but the True Blue. Not even these gems that had been on the Rift Stool and which would have been in plain sight. If Spike was our thief here, explain that. Why don't you?
What?
Score one for Twilight. So, dogs, if it couldn't have been Spike who was responsible for the crime, that doesn't leave too many options, does it?
The pony is forgetting.
Ugh, forgetting what?
The broken window.
Come again? I don't like where this is going.
The only evidence the pony has that there even was a break-in is the broken window. Your precious little suspect is the one who broke that window, of course. The pony accuses us of breaking in, but ignores the guilt of the only pony who could have been her culprit. If we stole from your precious prissy pony, then we would have needed to enter her house. But we did not.
Just a minute. Can you prove you didn't?
Perhaps the little investigation pony needs to brush up on her pony law. Innocent until proven guilty. Perhaps you haven't gotten to that chapter yet.
Yeah! Just when did these dogs become so legally inclined? This is ridiculous!
Besides, the answer to the pony's question is simple. The pony has nothing to even show how he could enter, let alone how he did. Your prissy pony keeps her door locked.
Look at this! This shows that Scootaloo couldn't have done it!
How?
Because, it shows that she, okay, never mind. Patience, Twilight. I need to clear Scootaloo's name, but I can't get her away from suspicion just by guessing like this.
The pony has nothing to even show how he could enter, let alone how he did. Your prissy pony keeps her door locked.
Wait a second. That's a very interesting thing to know.
I have to say.
What?
That Rarity keeps her doors locked. The other information I can see being useful, but I can't see how that information would help anything. Not unless you intended to do something with it.
Stop beating around the bush, Pony.
Rarity, this hooked gem fragment. You've never seen it before, right?
Why, no, darling. It's certainly not mine. I would never have a purpose for such an ill-shaped gemstone as that.
Which means this was left here by the culprit. Or should I say culprit? This carved piece of gemstone clearly only has one purpose. It picks locks. And where did it come from? Well, I've only seen one other example of carved gemstones like this. How fit! Namely, right here. You dogs carved that furniture and those keys, and you carved this lockpick too. Then in your haste to leave, you dropped it for us to find, which was your critical mistake. Tell me, dogs, if our perpetrator came in by breaking the window, what could this be for? How did you know that Rarity kept her door locked? How did you know that Scootaloo had been there? The answer is simple. You were there. You stole the true blue.
Well...
Not so fast, Pony!
Or not.
You've presented a nice story, Pony, but nice stories do not implicate dogs. Maybe we did make a hooked gem fragment. Maybe it was stolen from us. Does the Pony have evidence we use that for what she says?
No, I don't.
Besides, you, Pony, I've been ignoring a critical part of any case.
Here come our favorite legal eagles again. Or in this case, legal dogs.
It's simple. We have no motive.
What? You have no motive to steal a gigantic gem?
Let me explain for the slow ponies here. In case the Pony hadn't noticed, we have gems coming out of our ears in these caves! We've got so many gems that, as you so helpfully pointed out, we make our furniture from gems! So what if your little gem is you? We've got other huge gems lying around! You can have this stupid gem! There's no reason why we bought it more than any other gem! We have no attachment to it! We've never even seen it before!
Just a minute! No attachment to it. Nothing at all? Not even to an enormous gem?
No! The Pony will not make us repeat ourselves again!
Why does this bother me? And what was he about to say before he stopped himself? I can't help but feel like that's of vital importance. Maybe I should ask him again.
A gem that large can even be carved properly anyway.
Be honest, Mr. Dog. I'm not sure I buy the idea that you had no attachment to the true blue. You already alluded to the fact that big gems like this are kept out of sight, presumably in a safe, naturally. Yet, we saw clear as day that you have a safe that is as empty as can be, a safe that could instead be used to house a gem like that. There's only one possible reason for that.
And that would be?
I don't yet know how this ties into Rarity having the true blue yet, but... The only explanation for why the safe is empty is... You were stolen from, weren't you?
What? What gave you that idea, Pony? That's not why it's empty at all!
Now what? Alright, then why was it empty?
It's new, of course!
New?
Yes! Brand new! Never been used! We had a gem that we were going to put in it, but we haven't yet!
Is that actually plausible? Could it be brand new? I'm afraid that's not possible, Dogs. That safe can't be new.
Ha! The pony is bluffing! Show some proof!
I know I'm on the right track. There's a certain piece of evidence that shouldn't exist if the safe were truly brand new. All I need to do is present it. Fine, I will. The safe can't be new because of this.
Key? Perhaps the pony is unaware that safes with keyholes do tend to come with keys.
Oh, it's not the key that I'm interested in. It's where I found it. And perhaps even more importantly, the state I found it in. I know that this key wasn't found inside the caverns. I found this far outside the caverns near a bush, clearly discarded and lost. And I might add, right next to where Rarity found the true blue. Also, this key is identical in every way to that red key you showed me that opened your empty safe, meaning that it would open that safe as well. And furthermore, this key shows signs both of having been abandoned and of typical wear and tear, making it rather unlikely that it's remotely new. Thus, this key we found must be the original key to the safe. Meanwhile, the red key you showed me earlier was just a spare you made after the original one was stolen by the thief. If the safe was truly brand new, there would be no need for a spare key! Even you dogs can't have lost something so important that quickly!
No! But the pony doesn't have any evidence of this story at all! What evidence does the pony have that this thief even exists?
What's happened here? First, the thief stole this blue key, opened up that safe, and took the true blue. You pursued and caught him, but were unable to recover the true blue, because Rarity had already found its hiding place. When you learned this was because Rarity had taken possession of it, you started planning how you would get it back. And that all came to a head last night when you staged your heist of that gem. However, your perfect plan had a wrench thrown into it when Scootaloo, unaware of what was happening inside the boutique, crashed through the window and made Rarity come downstairs to see what was the matter. You hastily fled, but tripped over the stool, dropping the lockpick you had used to gain entry. Am I getting warm, Dogs?
That is... No! You're not! Maybe we did have a gem stolen from us! The pony has proven nothing!
Huh? Yes, I have! How haven't I?
It's simple, Pony. The Pony, for all her silly stories, has proven no link between the evidence and what she talks about. Lord Fizzy Pony had one gem, and a gem might have been stolen from us. So what? Besides, we got the stolen gem back. We just haven't put it back in the safe yet.
Just a minute. You can't.
You got it back, all right, from my house!
Please stop yelling, Miss Rarity.
I will not. The way in which you've been treating Twilight, it's simply shameful. I can't stand for it.
Rarity? I feel...
Frankly, I don't know who taught you dog's manners, but as a whole, you are all disgraceful! I have half a mind to haul you down to an etiquette class by your ears!
Rarity!
But I suppose I shan't be able to expect any more from mongrels who live in caves!
Rarity!
Oh! Yes, Twilight?
I don't think this is being... entirely productive. And you, Dad, you haven't proven that you've got your gem back.
We do not have to prove anything to you, Pony. So what if your little pony found a stupid gem near where our key was found? That proves nothing! Perhaps the pony should become a storyteller instead of an investigator. Lord,
didn't your mother tell you that honesty is the best policy?
What is the problem on about now?
I'm saying that you, Mr. Dog, are lying. You didn't get your gem back, and the location of the key wasn't a coincidence. When we got to the site at which Rarity found the true blue, there were two key things that we noticed, besides the enormous hole that was there.
I told you to fill that back in!
Oops.
Here's what I think really happened, Dogs. As I said before, you used to be in possession of the true blue, but it was stolen from you. The thief buried the gem as he was running away and then etched an X into a nearby rock to remind himself where it was. You caught up with him and forced him to show you where he buried it, but by that time, Rarity had already found it and walked away with it. You frantically dug anyways in the hopes that it was still there, as evidenced in the rather visible claw marks in the dirt, but to no avail. You went after it, found that Rarity was the one who had taken it, and then began to plot how to get it back, didn't you?
This is preposterous!
I don't see what's so preposterous about it.
Your dogs! Not my dogs! If we wanted our gem back, we would have just taken it back by force! Why would we stage a secret heist like the one you're accusing us of?
Oh, I think there's a pretty good reason for that, actually.
No! No, there isn't! No reason at all!
One. we're never going to try to take it back by force. That would be this, of course.
What's that? Your music and medicine letter?
Yeah! No! Of course not! I wouldn't write it on something like that, at least. Anyway, there was a very good reason why you didn't take the direct approach. One particular thing made it...
Interesting story. Who would have guessed that the Diamond Dogs would have been the culprit?
Yes. Who would have guessed that a group known in the past to be gem thieves would have stolen a large gem?
Scootaloo, please step forward for a moment.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Scootaloo, you came under immediate suspicion for this crime. However, it's now clear that you were simply a pony in the wrong place at the wrong time. For the crime of stealing Rarity's true blue gem, I hereby use the power vested in me as mayor to declare you not guilty.
Yeah! All right, Scootaloo!
All right, that matter having been settled, Twilight, there's still the matter of your status.
My status?
Of course. We did say that your status as an investigator was temporary.
We? You mean you?
Oh, let's not get caught up in details, Twilight. Anyway, the point is, as much doubt as I might have had in your abilities, you have proven yourself to be a capable investigator, what with your smashing good job with this crime. As such, Twilight, as of this moment, I hereby declare you an official permanent Ponyville investigator.
Yay! Wow. Thank you. It's an honor, Mayor.
All right. Well, I'm a very busy pony, so I'd best be going. All the best to you, Twilight. And I'm glad we could get this matter resolved, Rarity.
Very busy. More birthdays to organize, perhaps.
Well, all's well that ends well, my dears. I, for one, would be glad to get back to some good old normalcy around here.
Yeah, and I can't wait to finally get back to crusading. Come on, girls, let's go.
Just one moment. Dearest Scootaloo?
Yes?
That puts the matter of True Blue behind us, but there is still the matter of my window. Come here, Scootaloo.
I'd kind of rather stay here if it's all right with...
Scootaloo? Here! Now! Scootaloo, you broke the window to my boutique through reckless acts on your scooter. Not only that, you also then fled the scene and tried to hide the fact that you had been there, effectively lying to both me and every pony else by omission. Scootaloo, I am very, very disappointed.
But this! Rarity, she didn't...
I am very, very disappointed we did not do enough to convince you to trust us with the truth.
Huh?
Scootaloo, we are your friends. And a true friend is someone who you can trust to absolutely listen to you, to understand you, and to trust that you have always had the best intentions at heart in everything you do. Isn't that right, Twilight?
Right you are, Rarity.
This could have been much, much easier if you had just told us what had happened from the start, don't you think?
Yeah, you're right, Rarity. I'm sorry.
Apology most certainly accepted, darling. Now, run along and play with your friends.
Okay. Thanks, Rarity.
Rarity, what about the window?
Never mind about that, Twilight. My windows were due to be remodeled anyway. Can't let this boutique look get old after all.
That oddly explains a lot. Well, I guess that's everything. I'll leave you be to get the rest of the boutique in order, Rarity.
All right. Thank you ever so much for all that you've done for me today, Twilight. It is most appreciated, I assure you. Take care.
See you around, Rarity.
Dear Princess Celestia, I'm writing to you from a positively delightful party Pinky has put on for Rarity, whose birthday is today.
Come on, Twilight! Let's dance the night away! Woo!
In a minute, Pinky! Anyways, I don't know if you've already heard, but I'm now an official Ponyville investigator. Pretty neat, huh? I even got a little badge and everything! Pinky, we have hooves.
Oh, right!
Sometimes I really worry about Pinky. Where was I? Oh, right. Anyway, we can talk more about that later. For now, I wanted to give you a friendship report. I've learned two very valuable lessons about friendship that I'd like to share with you. First, I learned that honesty really is the best policy. If your friends are true friends, then they'll listen to and be understanding of anything you might need to tell them, even if it's not good. A lot of problems in life can be avoided in the long run just by being honest with others. Second, I learned that sometimes the best way to catch an adversary off guard is to show a little kindness and generosity. Even if someone's been unkind to you in the past, that doesn't mean that you should always be mean to them. An eye for an eye can lead just to an endless cycle of unhappiness. Who knows? Perhaps you might even get through to them. Maybe. Your faithful student, Twilight Sparkle.
Walks up to the cafe owner, who promptly looks at her and says,
Winnie Bill, that's your cow!
Oh, right! The owner says,
Hey, why the long face?
Long face! Get it? Get it?
So, do we have our cutie marks yet?
Every pony, gather around for the photo. Don't forget to smile.
Sweetie Belle, get back.
Official Ponyvale investigator. Kind of has a certain ring to it, I suppose. And heck, I got a shiny new badge out of it, too! Not so shabby, huh? Although, speaking of badges, I wonder whatever happened to that Canterlot investigative team.
Nope, this definitely isn't Ponyville either. But how? The train goes right there from Canterlot. Hey, don't look at me. You're the one with the map. Map? I never had a map. For Celestia's sake, the train only has two stops. Forget it. Let's just keep walking.
Oh, well. Ponyville's usually pretty quiet, but I wonder what other cases I might get to solve in the future. I have a lot to learn as an investigator, but I'll do my best in whatever case comes next.